Hey guys, what's going on? Today is September 28th. We have a new over-the-air balance patch, so let's just dive right in. I'm going to look at this, and we can look at some of the stats for these cards too to see how the changes fit into the meta. First up, we have Galactus. Does it help if I highlight the whole thing? Yeah, it helps enough. All right. They're taking him down from a 6-cost 7 power card to a 6-cost 5 power card. Basically saying he's doing better than he wanted to. They don't want to change cards just because Eliath, or they don't want to change Eliath just because it would work with Galactus. Eliath is almost the same thing as when they used to have Spider-Man. I think this is just a good change. I always say Galactus is a card that should be bad. It shouldn't be a meta relevant card. It should be something you try to like sometimes pull off a Galactus win. Sometimes you trick somebody or they got, you know, you catch them not paying attention. And then the way it's been is that Galactus is just strong, and whatever Galactus goes off, it changes the rules of the game so much that it makes it a different game. So I'm always happy to see him just take him down a notch. I don't think he should be a meta relevant card. Okay, next up, Kitty Pryde. I personally have been using this deck, this Shuri Kitty deck, and it's really, really effective. I've gone up a whole bunch of ranks because of it, so I get why they want to change it. It's a pretty heavy nerf, though. It makes it, she goes from a 1-2 to a 1-0. It's essentially where she was in the first iteration when she got 2 power when she returned to your hand, but now she gets 1 power, so she's literally half as good. That's pretty bad. It's going to take a lot to get her to be a valuable card. Like, it's, you know, just on her own, if you play her every turn, she's a 6-cost, 6-power card. That's not very good. If you hit her with, like, the Dream in this deck, you go, you know, Kitty on 1, say Kitty on 2, Forge and Kitty on 3. That gets her up to 6 power. Then Kitty and, what's the card? Hulkbuster. That adds 5 more. So that's 12 power. And then you Shuri, so that's still 24 power if you get everything to go right. You don't always get everything to go right, but I think that's the point. The deck was just really strong, and Kitty has kind of this unbalanced priority thing where you're putting, like, you play Shuri and you play Kitty Pryde and you have 20 power on board, then it goes back to your hand so that the opponent cannot interact with it if they don't have priority. Rather, if your opponent has priority, they just can't interact with your Kitty Pryde and all that power, which is a little broken. So I get it. I'm gonna have to find a new deck to climb, probably. Though the deck, you know, it still works with Red Skull, it works with Vision, you know, it's a good deck. So it might lose a couple of points, but I think it'll still work. It's not as good. All right, moving on, we have Psylocke. Nobody plays Psylocke anymore. So they're giving her a 1 power boost. She's now a 2-2. Same effect. There's a lot of ramping going on in the current metagame, but it's all based on Electro and Wave, really. Magic, they say, you know, kind of. I don't know. I go off the top of my head, like, if you play her on curve, it lets you get a 4-cross card down early. But Zabu does that better, right? And you can play her on turn 4 to get a 6 down early alongside a 2-2. Like, it's always a little bit like, what's the specific goal? I used to use her in my Nimrod deck back when that deck was my number one deck by far. You know, you play her on 3, the same turn you would play Electro, but you could follow up with more stuff when you played Psylocke. I don't know if the 1 power makes it come back. I might try it with Nimrod again. That deck used to be better. It's terrible now. It's absolutely unplayable now. We'll see if it works. I don't think the 1 power makes that much of a difference with Psylocke. Next up is Squirrel Girl. She goes from a 1-1 to a 1-2. And the effect is the same. I mean, she's one of the cards you start with. I guess that's, like, it makes it 4 power total for 1 cost. She's not really played much outside of in the very early stages of the game. They're changing it. This little thing they have down here about she's been acting pretty spooky. You should be careful walking through Central Park. I think that just refers to how they have this new zombie squirrel, like, variant. I wouldn't be shocked if Central Park has zombie squirrels come out as well as Squirrel Girl. Or there's, like, a new variant you get. Maybe that one has the zombie swirls. It's more, like, promotional, I think. I don't really see it becoming a playable card. Snogard's Auroras got changed. They both go to 3 cost, with the bear getting 1 extra bump in power. They say that they just don't want the Auroras to be so efficient. They used to be 2 cost, 3 power cards, so they were just like basically good cards. I played her in a Cerebro deck. She gave you 2 threes, so that was pretty cool. I don't think that works anymore. The bear is 4. I did used to run this Loki Surfer deck I have queued up here. Now you get 2 3 cost cards, and it also buffs Loki. So this might be a buff to my Loki Surfer deck. This deck was not bad. It was not bad at all. Can we see it over here? Wins a 60% win rate. It was pretty good. So maybe they buffed my Surfer deck, my Loki Surfer deck. That'd be nice. Those are the changes. I'd like to just take a look at the stats right now. It's interesting because we see, for example, Kitty Pryde is way up by the top, but not everything. Like Wave is still played more. Yeah, like if you look at the win rates, Kitty Pryde, I'd say Wave is similarly strong. And there's always going to be things like Nebula, Sunspot, just a strong card all across and really highly played. Galactus, surprisingly, a little bit further down the list, getting less play than Blue Marvel. Who'd have thought? But you see the when played win rate. I think whenever something gets to be like 63% win rate or probably over 60, it's when you really need to change it. We're sort of pushing that with Dr. Doom, though generally people accept that. Eliath is annoying, but of course that's part of the Galactus-Eliath interaction. Kitty, not so much. Kind of fits in line, so I'm surprised that she got changed. Maybe it's because I was playing her deck though, so I'm like partial to her being a good card. Nobody ever likes it when the deck they play gets nerfed. Loki is still strong. That I think they mention here, they mention in the balance changes. Looking at this, it says it right here. We're locking in these changes with the next week's patch on the horizon. So I bet they'll change Loki in some way in next week's patch. So all of these things are kind of temporary. I wouldn't be shocked if the collector gets reverted after they nerf Loki. But I guess we'll see. So, what do you guys think? How do you feel about the changes? Which ones do you like? Which ones do you not like? Do you think you'll be using Squirtle more often? Either way, thanks for watching. Remember to like, follow, and subscribe, and keep snapping. Pow!